right off stage, we have Kevin Feige making his way over to us, executive producer of Marvel Studios Shang-Chi and The Legend of the Ten Rings. Hello!
Hi there, hi there.
Hi!
It has been too long since we've done this.
It has been way too long since we've done this. 2019.
Yeah. Wow.
Yeah.
Well, did we know how far it would be until the next one.
So how does it feel to be on the carpet again?
I love it. You know, we did a slightly smaller fan event at Black Widow, which was nice. This feels, as you can see, and I hope, do you have a crane here? I hope you get a shot of the carpet. Come on.
Get the carpet.
Yeah. It's awesome here. It's really great.
I love the fact that you show up for your celebration and you're still in producer mode, producing the carpet with the Gymshots and Gareth.
We have the crane, and we do, so that's good. Yeah.
No, I love it. That's why we love what you do. And we have to talk about the hat. Yeah, there you go. Yes. We have to talk about the hat, your tradition.
Yes. I'm bald, so I wear a hat a lot.
That's the tradition. That's the way to do it. Style.
We love the design.
Our Shang-Chi, yes. Felt appropriate for this evening.
So let's talk about this new superhero joining the MCU and the origin. Why was this the right time for Shang-Chi?
Well, I've said that it has been almost the entirety of my 20 years at Marvel. This has been on a list of movies we dream of making, because the story, as people will soon see, of this son who has this very complex relationship with his father was always fascinating to us. Literally going back to my early days at Marvel, it was on a list of great characters that we could do. Finally, here we are, tapping it into the Legend of the Ten Rings, which is also going to be fun for MCU fans tracking that logo throughout the movies. And the cast, who I hope you will be talking to soon, is what has brought this to life. And Destin, who I think you did talk to, has done an amazing job in bringing this new. It's been a beat since we brought a new origin story of a new Marvel hero to the screen, and Simu's done a tremendous job.
So tell us about Simu a little bit. What made him the right guy for the job?
Along with our casting director, Serafin, scoured the earth for Shang-Chi.
She didn't just read Twitter?
No, she scoured the earth. And tweeted, which we found out after he was cast. But he had an amazing audition. He had amazing, really done some great work up in Canada, and just brought, as you will find soon, if you haven't already met him, a relatability to it that all Marvel heroes need. But he can also, you know, achieve, we believe, that sort of iconic status to stand within the pantheon of Marvel heroes.
Now, what corner of the MCU does Shang-Chi bring to the team?
Well, it's a good question. You know, he taps into a couple of different things. I'm dancing around some spoilers in the movie.
Without saying a thing.
But it is, you know, it is so much more. You know, clearly a lot of the comics and a lot of Destin's references and all of our references for this film were based in the kung fu genre, which is something we hadn't done before, obviously, in Marvel. The fight scenes done by the now late, great Brad Allen is such a testament to his legacy, which I can't wait for people to see. He was part of Jackie Chan's stunt team, and I was looking forward to a long collaboration with him, and we lost him a couple of weeks ago. But it also, that's just the starting point, because the power of the Ten Rings and the legend thereof, you'll learn about as well. And it really allows us to do both these incredible fight scenes and yet bring it in a way that taps into the biggest of what Marvel can do.
I love that we're going to have the action and the adventure and the excitement and also the intimacy of the family story and what Shang-Chi means to a lot of us who can look up and see someone who looks like us on the screen.
100%, and that's something that we want to continue to do at Marvel, and the books have done for years, and now finally we're doing that in the movies, and that everybody should be able to look up at that big screen, on a big screen, in a theater, and see themselves reflected the best at them. We talked about Simu, also talking about Tony Leung, because you mentioned the family aspect of the movie, which I still don't think people are quite ready for what Tony brings to this movie and what the relationship and how unique it is and how emotional this movie becomes.
Well, Marvel is known for working with legendary actors. I mean, Michael Douglas, you've had Robert Redford, here you have Tony, you have Michelle Yeoh, so we are in for a treat.